Members of the Board of Education, distinguished guests, district administrators, faculty, parents, relatives, friends, and members of the class of 2021. Good evening, and welcome to the annual commencement exercises for Wethersfield High School, and welcome home to Cove Park. The class of 2021 is now present and prepared for these academic ceremonies. To officially open tonight's ceremony, I am pleased to introduce Mr. Tiago Nguyen, President of the National Honor Society.
As president of the National Honor Society, I am pleased and proud to ask you to join me in the Pledge of our allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Never mind, I'm back. I'm honored to call upon my fellow senior classmate, Franco Tomeno, who will sing our national anthem. Please join me in this tribute to our country.
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Whoa, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home?
This evening, Ross Tyne and Eric Franco from the class of 2022 who are serving as marshals for this evening, and also to those faculty, staff members, and parents who have worked so intensely in preparing these commencement exercises. Thank you to our graduation secretaries, Suzanne Curtin and Barbara Bellis, who have coordinated the graduation ceremony. Thank you to the parents who have coordinated, fundraised, organized the safe after graduation party and who will be supervising that this evening at Wethersfield High School. I would also like to take a moment to recognize our assistant principals, our athletic director, Terry Yusko, Tyler Webb, and Michael Maltesi, our school counselors, our faculty members for their outstanding education and dedication efforts in the education of our students at Wethersfield High School. This is truly a team effort, and the diplomas that are being presented this evening not only reflect the hard work of the students, but also the perseverance and commitment of elementary school teachers, middle school teachers, central office administrators and staff, paraprofessionals, secretaries, custodians, security guards, maintenance workers, and cafeteria staff as well. At this time, could I please have all parents stand up? All parents. And I know you're comfortable, sorry about that. Congratulations and a large thank you to all of our parents. You've enabled your children to reach this milestone, and I know they appreciate your efforts. Thank you. You may be seated. And now may we please have the grandparents in the crowd stand. Just as important. You have seen these children as infants, and now you see them on the brink of adulthood. Your nurturing and caring efforts on behalf of your grandchildren have helped make them the people that they are today. On behalf of the class of 2021, thank you, grandparents. Yeah. At this time, I am proud to reintroduce our next speaker, the president of the class of 2021, Tiago Nguyen.
Can't get enough of me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tiago Nguyen, men and women before you. To the class of 2021, we've grown up together, learned together, and impacted one another in unimaginable ways. High school is designed to be flexible, comfortable, forgiving, which fosters experimentation and the learning of lessons prior to the real world. One lesson that I learned through my time in high school that I feel can be applied broadly is to seize the initiative. As defined, the initiative is the power or opportunity to act or take charge before others do. Simply meaning, take chances, take opportunities, and take risks that will better position your life and your future. When the call to act arrives, don't sit still and wait for the problem to solve itself or wait for someone else to solve the problem for you. Embrace the challenge and embrace the chance to make a difference. The initiative can take many forms: your schoolwork, your hobbies, your relationships, and the countless other opportunities that present themselves in your life. Now, as much as I try to convince myself and my parents that I was born with some incredible wisdom, I learned this lesson through failure and seeing missed opportunities move out of reach. Many times I've delayed, second-guessed, and said no to myself before someone else had. And it took me many mistakes to realize that the initiative has a time limit. By sitting too long or analyzing too much, the initiative can be lost or seized by someone else. As we move forward into college, the military, the workforce, or another path after high school, opportunities will constantly present themselves. Using better judgment, seize those opportunities to better yourself. Because greatness isn't something that you wait around for, it must be sought after and seized. And work hard, work ferociously, and campaign relentlessly for what you want, because no one else will. Simply, you are your biggest champion, and you will fight as hard as you can for yourself. The moment you stop seizing opportunities and taking the initiative is the very same moment that life begins to pass you by. Now, delivering on my promise to make this short, to the class of 2021, guys, this is really it. Soon we will begin our lives and move in our own directions. But remember the fun of high school, which didn't come from tests, quizzes, or projects, but it came from the people. And I can profoundly say that this class is filled with some truly magnificent people. It has been an absolute honor to have met and grown alongside you. And I look forward to hearing the success and the impact that the class of 2021 has upon the world. But no matter where life takes you, seize opportunities, take the initiative, and lead yourself and your life towards victory. Thank you.
I would now like to congratulate Carrie Nguyen for achieving the rank of salutatorian for the 2021 graduating class of Wethersfield High School. Carrie Nguyen has a competitive spirit that motivates her to master any challenge she faces. She takes great pride and satisfaction in excelling academically while remaining well-balanced with her extracurricular activities. Carrie's resume of activities is robust. She's been the vice president of her senior class for the past 2 years. Carrie was also a member of the student council, math team, and Skills 21 club. She has contributed greatly to our musical program by participating in the string ensemble and with the musical theater pit orchestra for the productions of Fiddler on the Roof and the Addams Family. Outside of school, Carrie volunteered to crochet stuffed animals for the Mercy House. She is focused on the development of younger students through volunteering at the Festival Orchestra and the Family Hour of Code. She was included in a student panel for Expo Fest kickoff with EdAdvance. Carrie is a member of the National Honor Society, National Social Studies Honor Society, and Spanish National Honor Society. In her junior year, Carrie was a semi-finalist with the Connecticut Scholars Essay Contest and also received the Harvard Book Award. This fall, Carrie will be attending the University of Connecticut, where she will be majoring in biomedical engineering. Carrie's passion for helping others will be woven in her medical career path. WHS will truly miss this caring, passionate, and engaged student. I am honored to introduce to you the salutatorian of the class of 2021, Carrie Wynn.
Fellow graduates. As you all know, my name is Carrie, and I'm so excited and honored to be delivering the salutatorian with us today. Not only for your presence today, but for the sacrifices, love, and support that have allowed us to get here. To the parents who have cheered us on since day one, worked tirelessly to support us, and loved us endlessly. To the grandparents, siblings, and friends who have been our backbones. To the teachers who show up to work every day with enthusiasm, stay after school, and invest in us just to see us succeed, and the administration and staff who make WHS a community we are proud to call home, thank you. I speak for every one of my classmates when I say that, although we don't express it nearly as often as we should, we are grateful beyond words for all that you have done. These past 15 months have certainly not been what any of us expected. And in light of what we've been through, it feels today like we've walked through the valley and finally made it up the mountain. This is our mountaintop moment. But the struggles of the past year have not been for nothing. If there's one thing I've learned, it's that every part of life deserves to be celebrated. The peaks, the valleys, and everything in between. I think we're now beginning to realize the value of those ordinary, everyday moments that can seem so forgettable at the time. The classes you've sat in so often that they blur into the background. The teachers and friends you see so often, they feel as if they'll just always be there. But now things are changing, and those everyday moments are not our everydays anymore. That's part of why today is so bittersweet. We're realizing just how much we'll miss those moments that we used to rush past. From this point forward, we have a choice. A choice to find value in the seemingly mundane, to not spend any season waiting for the next. Many of us spent all of high school waiting for college, and before that, all of middle school waiting to get to high school. If we don't open our eyes now to the beauty of the ordinary, we'll spend all of life waiting for college graduation, marriage, promotions, retirement, any of the million things that vie for our attention. Choose the better path. Choose to walk through the season you're in, no matter how boring it may seem at the time, with the fullest intentionality and gratitude. Treasure the moments before their memories. We have a similar decision to make when we walk through life's valleys. Challenges come, and sometimes you have no choice in the matter. But you do have a choice in whether or not you'll throw away these seasons of trial. Like it or not, COVID-19 won't be the last challenge that we face. In life, we are guaranteed trouble. But life's challenges refine us. They mold us into the people that we're meant to become, just as centuries upon centuries of heat and pressure mold lumps of coal into beautiful diamonds. If nature itself displays the pattern of a purpose behind the pain, of beauty from ashes, why can't it be true for us too? Recently, in Mrs. Adamson's civics class, we watched the movie Remember the Titans, which you've probably all seen at least once in your WPS career. And I was reminded of the story of Gary Bertier. Gary was the star athlete of his high school football team, an unbelievably talented athlete bound for college football and likely the NFL, when a car accident left him paralyzed from the waist down. He had a choice to make. Do I let this moment define me, or do I define it? Do I stay here for the rest of my life, or do I use it for good? If you haven't seen it, you can probably guess which he chose, since I'm telling you his story today. Gary went on to become a Paralympian and an advocate for the special needs community, turning his challenge into triumph. Many of the biggest names in history faced similar setbacks. Thomas Edison failed 1,000 times before inventing the light bulb. Walt Disney was fired from his first job for a supposed lack of creativity. Michael Jordan was cut from his varsity basketball team sophomore year. And Steven Spielberg was rejected from film school twice before going on to direct Jurassic Park, Schindler's List, Jaws, and E.T. The one thing they all have in common is that they didn't stop at the setback. And then there are the examples we've had right in front of us. We all remember Mr. Nick. Mr. Nick, who didn't let his illness become his identity, who never stopped doing what he loved, who smiled brighter than anyone, even on the worst days. He loved spending his days with us, and I'm sure that he would be proud of all of us today. And I think he would have a similar message too. Troubles will come, but we can choose what to do with them. In whatever season, mountain, valley, or in between, you get to choose what you'll make of your circumstances. And I hope that you choose not to let a moment go to waste. Congratulations, class of 2021. I look forward to seeing what our journeys will hold. Thank you.
Brian Pugliele, could you come up?
Good evening, everybody. My name is Brian Pugliele, and I am the secretary for the class of 2021. I would now like to introduce the mayor of the town of Wethersfield, the Honorable Michael L. Rell, who will offer his greetings. Mr. Mayor.
Good evening, class of 2021, family and friends. Superintendent Emmett, Board of Education Chair Gary, and honorary guests, thank you for inviting me to address this outstanding class of students. I will keep this brief, as this is your night to hear from your friends and classmates, a night you will be remembered for many of tonight you will be remembered with many of your friends and colleagues. Tonight we celebrate your resilience, your perseverance, we celebrate you. It is no secret that this year and a half has been a challenge. Starting last March, when your world came to a halt, you acclimated to assignments online. You returned in the fall with a new perspective on remote learning. And finally, this winter, you were able to reunite as a class back in the classroom. Guided by your parents and teachers, you were able to navigate senior year and make decisions for your future. This adaptation is a testament to who you are and who you will become as you go on to pursue this next phase in your life. You now know you can handle any challenge head on and come out a stronger person. My children have a book many of you may have heard of, The Boy, the Mole, the Fox, and the Horse. The book opens with a common question: what do you want to be when you grow up? Kind, the boy replies. Next, the boy asks, what do you think success is? To love, says the mole. Further into the story, the boy asks the horse, what is the bravest thing you've ever said? Help, replied the horse. As you accept your diploma tonight and start the next chapter of your life, be curious, be kind, love with an open heart, and don't be afraid to ask for help. These four things will guide you down the path of success. Congratulations on this wonderful accomplishment, and I wish you all the very best in your future endeavors.
everybody. I am back again, this time to introduce the chairperson of the Wethersfield Board of Education, Mr. Charles Carey.
Thank you for the introduction. On behalf of the Board of Education, it is an honor to be speaking here today to the Central Office Administration, to our high school administration and faculty, family, friends, and most importantly, you, the graduates of 2021. As being a golfer, I'll start off with a quote by Bobby Jones. He was an American amateur golfer who was one of the most influential figures in the history of golf. He says, golf is the closest game to the game we call life. You get bad breaks from good shots, you get good breaks from bad shots, but you have to play the ball where it lies. You've had to learn from home, you've had your winter sports championships abruptly stopped, you've had spring sports canceled, spring musicals canceled after countless hours of rehearsal. It never occurred that you look for, countless activities never occurred that you look forward to, and many other things that have happened, both positive and negative. But as we look back throughout the past year and a half of this pandemic, we've had our good breaks and our bad breaks, but it's important that we've always stayed positive and made the most of what has been given to us. It might have been easier to think of all the things that you've lost, shortened, or changed and start to feel angry. But this quote is telling you, in spite of all, you have to make the most of what life has thrown at you. It is important to always stay positive. Many things will happen to you in life that will have you doubting yourself and making you feel like you're a failure. But you always have to keep your head up and make the best of it. Another quote that I came across during this pandemic that has resonated says, success is not a measure of how big you can dream, it's a measure of how much you can do. Dreaming or doing is a choice that will mean a difference between failure or success. I'm a graduate of Wethersfield High School and I graduated here 25 years ago. Many things have happened on my road today that could have made me give up and stop pursuing my dreams, but I've always been the person to think everything happens for a reason and I'll become a better person for it. So as you sit here today, I ask, what is your dream and how will you make it a reality? Go out and do what needs to be done in order to be successful. Whether it's in the classroom, on the field, or just making yourself a better person, you need to do it. You control your own destiny. There is nothing that I can say that can make up for many of the lost moments of the pandemic, but it's caused, but that's balanced by your perseverance in working through the historical, challenging time. It isn't about the hardship, it's about meeting the task and getting through it and learning from it. Maybe we all have learned a little more about ourselves, realized how strong our families are, and how life is not measured always by success, but by the setbacks and how we respond. Your parents didn't give up. We worked hard to make sure you are ready for the world that awaits your energy, your dreaming, and the will to carry it out. If you want it bad enough, then work hard to get it. Yes, you'll have your ups and downs along the way, but the journey you take will be worth it. I believe life is made up of those moments along the way, and what you make of those moments will determine the path you take or the person that you become. It is up to you to choose the path after graduation. Remember to have no regrets for the choices you have to make and always learn from them. Embrace a growth mindset. I've learned a lot in my lifetime, and I know I will continue to learn as I grow as a person, a husband, a father, a professional, and a public servant. I'll leave you with one more quote from another golfer, Bryson DeChambeau. He says, I'm not really smart, but I'm dedicated. I can be good at anything if I love it and dedicate myself. I love history, I love science, I love music, I love golf. I love learning and I love life. So Wethersfield Class of 2021, I challenge you to find something you love and dedicate yourself to it and continue on in your journey of life. Now, I have the pleasure of presenting a special award entitled the Wethersfield Board of Education Chairman Award. This award has been established to recognize the outstanding achievement of a Wethersfield High School student. This year's recipient is Xavier White. Xavier is well. Xavier is well liked by all his peers and possesses qualities that we all strive to have. He is kind, compassionate, funny, and willing to try new things outside of his comfort zone. Xavier has demonstrated success both on track and cross-country team and academically. You will recognize Xavier in the halls of Wethersfield High School because he is the one with the contagious smile on his face each and every day. He is an integral part of Wethersfield community. Knock, knock, who's there? It's Xavier White. I would like to call upon board members John Cassio and then Ken Lesser to approach the podium to present this year's Board of Education Awards of Excellence.
Good evening, everyone. Are you enjoying the night? What a difference a year makes, right? Okay, let's keep going. Since 1995, 26 years ago, the Wethersfield Board of Education initiated the Board of Education Excellence Award. This year, we have two individuals. It could have been more than two, but as you can see, this class of 2021 excels in everything. We've changed it a little bit. This year, these two recipients will receive 2021 Ford Focus. Only kidding. The budget's going to be approved on Monday night. Are we engaged? Okay, are we listening? You're going to only receive a plaque. The student ranks in the top 15% of the graduating class. The recipient is an outstanding school citizen who has performed significant service in the school and their community. The recipient is of soul, sound, moral, and ethical character and has made a significant contribution to the school and community. This year's recipients are truly worthy of this honor. It is my pleasure to introduce the first recipient of the 2021 Wethersfield Board of Education Award of Excellence. I'd like this individual to come forward. That is Carrie Wynn. In her time at Wethersfield High School, Carrie has been a significant impact on the school. Come up here, Carrie. On the school and the community. Carrie has been focused on helping others develop their skills and making a positive impact within the community. Carrie advocated for the wants and the needs of her peers by running for vice president of her class. And as you can see, she represented you well, not only as the class vice president, but as this year's salutatorian. She worked to improve communication and fundraising efforts to make events affordable for the members of her class of 2021. Carrie has shared her love for music with others by volunteering at the festival orchestra, and she helps kids tune instruments and guide them through music reading. Carrie's goal of volunteering for the Family Hour of Code was to introduce elementary age children to the world of technology. Carrie views the world through a problem-solving lenses. With the Skills 21 Club, Carrie and her team developed a sea turtle app called Shelly in 2019, which highlighted sea turtle endangerment and the need to protect our oceans. In 2020, the team developed an app streamlined post-secondary options with appropriate support services for students with autism spectrum. Carrie, while pursuing a career in medicine or assistive devices like prosthesis and artificial organs that will help improve people's way of life. Carrie Wynn is very worthy of the recipient of the 2021 Board of Education Award. And we thank her for all her countless contributions to our school, to your class, and to the community. Carrie, thank you so much. Mr. Lesser, top that.
I can't top that. John, you're terrific. I'm going to ask my recipient that I'm going to pass the word to come up and follow what John's lead. So Tiago Wynn. So my name is Ken Lesser, and I'm honored to introduce the second recipient of the 2021 Wethersfield Board of Education Award of Excellence. I am pleased to present the 2021 Board of Education Award of Excellence to Tiago Wynn. For his senior year, Tiago was appointed student representative to the Board of Education. He takes this role very seriously. Watching him in action and sitting next to him at Board of Education meetings is exciting. Fears cast aside, he carries himself with conviction, and there's no doubt that he did all his work with due diligence. Tiago takes pride in all of his work, whether he is consulting with his fellow students to make sure he is obtaining factual results or doing projects for his classes. Tiago still makes time in his demanding academic and athletic schedule for volunteerism. Each holiday season, he gives approximately 6 hours to selling Christmas trees and wreaths to benefit the Chrysalis Center, an organization that assists Hartford's poor by supplying food, job assistance, and other needs. He helped at the center's food pantry. Tiago also worked with his parents to start Green Shield, a nonprofit which raises money for veterans. Any spare time is spent on an old car, performing automotive maintenance. It has become a father-son activity where his father shows him what to do and Tiago performs the work. Rotors, brake pads, e-brake, headlight, this homemade mechanic is ready for the next car repair. This is one more example of Tiago's ties to his family. Another tie is his brother enlisting in the Marine Corps last year, influenced Tiago to do his research, ask questions, and to reflect. He said, "It opened my eyes to the possibility for me to serve. A wave of patriotism came over me. I want to serve and give back." Tiago's innate talents, intelligence, leadership skills, and sense of service will make him excel in the military, and especially during college and beyond. It is my privilege to present the second Board of Education Award to Tiago Wynn.
Congratulations. Well done. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good evening, parents, family members, elected officials, staff members, and of course, the graduates of 2021. I recognize that my placement in the program puts me directly between you and your shining moment. So as your longtime principal, Mr. Thomas Moore, used to say, I will be brief. When I sent out the school messenger message on March 12, 2020, closing the district effective the following Monday, I never dreamed what would transpire. What we all thought would be a two-week break became the loss of the rest of the school year. The structure of the school day was lost. The social connections were reduced to sitting in front of a screen. The traditions were paused, and events that lead to fond high school memories were canceled. Even this year, while you returned to school, it was anything but a normal year. Over the past year and a half, you have gained a deep understanding of the realities of life. That is, we don't always get what we want. Each Wethersfield High School graduating class that I have had the privilege of seeing receive your diploma has had their own unique personality. And for you, the class of 2021, that word, resilient, fits perfectly. If there is one thing that you have learned over the past year and a half, it is that you are resilient. In spite of the restrictions, you found a way to stay engaged academically. Now, there may have been the rare occasion or two where the Chromebook camera turned off during class to facilitate a little extra sleep time, but I am sure those instances were few and far between. You stayed engaged artistically. The virtual musical productions over the course of the year were simply breathtaking. Your tribute to Mr. Nicholas was emotional and was a real tribute to a beloved teacher here at Wethersfield High School. The return of student artists to the art gallery this year for a socially distanced art show, and the performers back to the stage for the spring production provided a welcomed dose of normalcy. While athletics looked different this past year, no amount of restrictions, quarantines, or positive cases could break you down as teams. You now possess a greater understanding of the importance of connecting with others. You possess the ability to adapt to challenges. Your resilience and perseverance over this year is proof of that. You were able to creatively navigate this most unusual learning environment and to stay connected to your peers, your school, and your community. So as you graduate this evening, I ask you to reframe your thinking. Focus not on what wasn't. Focus on what will be. Each and every one of you has the ability to make a mark on society, no matter where your path takes you. You have a voice that can shape the future while calling out inequities of the past. You have the ability to make the world a better place. Indeed, your potential is limitless. I know I speak on behalf of the entire community when I say that we are so very proud of you. To the Wethersfield class of 2021, I wish you all the best. Thank you. And now, if I could please have Treasurer Victoria Villagra come forward.
Good evening, my name is Victoria Villagra, and I am the treasurer of the class of 2021. At this time, I would like to invite Ms. Tara Yusko, assistant principal of the senior class, to the podium for the presentation of the class of 2021.
Thank you, Victoria. Superintendent Emmett, Chairperson Carey, members of the Board of Education, as assistant principal of the senior class of Wethersfield High School, I certify that the members present this evening have completed the requirements for their diplomas or certificates as prescribed by the State of Connecticut and the Wethersfield Board of Education. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to present to you the Wethersfield High School graduating class of 2021. At this time, I'd like to introduce class advisor, Ms. Ashley Cavanaugh, for the reading of the names.
Valedictorian Sophie Gustafson. Class Vice President and Salutatorian, Carrie Wynn. Top Scholar, placing third in her class, Jennifer Faith Breglio. Top 10 Scholar, placing fourth, Nazanin Zayer. Top 10 Scholar, placing fifth, Michael Duke Belak. Top 10 Scholar, placing sixth, Rita Kondusha. Top 10 Scholar, placing seven, Excel Leonard. Top 10 scholar, placing 8, Catherine Elizabeth Griffin. Top 10 scholar, placing 9, Lindsay Ann Pia. Top 10 scholar, placing 10th, and class secretary, Brian Puglielli. Class president, Tiago Nguyen. Class treasurer, Victoria Villagra. Aisha Afzal.
Thomas Mario
Thomas Mario Aglico. Jana Agoli.
Oh my God, Chris, what the?
Lauren Agoli. Ava Lynn Amedovic. Gabriella Rose Amodio. Adeline Andino. Dana Elizabeth Andrews. Kate Lauren Anzaday. Megan Appel. Crystal Lee Arroyo. Michaela Ashley. Kevin Thomas Avery. Christian John Behuth. Joseph Ballett. Aaron Lena Bankowski. David Barajas. Fatma Sena Bark. Camille Rose Barone. Nadia Elizabeth Baroni. Spencer James Bartone. Anaya Bida. Asmita Bachere. Alphonse Bichaku. Emily Sarah Bellowick. Ava Belinda. Kristen Taylor Blake. Ivana Blazovic. Lynn Siomata Blow. Michael John Bobbin. Isabella Marie Bonvasuto. Jacob Bradley. Audrey Bucari. Philip Randall Bucci III. Sydney Catherine Boudet. Juliana Alexia Bonapane. Dominic G. Butler. Olivia Butler. Stephen John Bisco III. Adriana Cabrera. Salvatore Sebastian Calafiore. Alejandro Caldas. Lucas J. Cardoso. Liliana Carmela Cartiera. Morgan Cathcart. Aaron Benjamin Kawila. Kendall Maruka Kawila. Erica Lynn Christie. Christopher Emmanuel Chico. William E. Civitello. Amanda Coelho. Eamon Coggins. Caitlin Colty. Isabella Contreras. Evan Grant Copa. Elisa Relina Correa Rosa. Bryce Hedlund Cox. Danny Cruz. Alexandria D'Onofrio. Richard Scott Darrell Jr. Madeline Rose Day. Mia Rose DeStefani. Sarah Long Dietrich. Alicia Michelle DeCenzo. Matthew James DeLiva. Demetrios Demisianos. Dynasty Maria Ellis. Darnell Ellison Jr. Alicia Etienne. Matthew Fletcher. Natalia Fontanez Rivera. Kate Elizabeth Fodi. Owen Gagne. Gianna Marie Garrow. Haddon Gaunt. Hannah Elizabeth Gebhard. Faith Maria Giannini. Alexander James Ginter. Haley Gomez. Chastity Gonzalez. Charles Connor Gray. Megan Rachel Gregorski. Aaron Michael Guay. Gabriella Maria Galino. Layla Guster.
Hallinan?
Yeah.
Declan Hallinan.
Yeah, Declan!
Anna Elizabeth Hart. John Charles Hart. Noah Logan Haskins. Charles William Hayes. Kennedy Hill. Jonathan Joseph Hubschmidt. Eric Huffman.
Semsa Hurek.
Semsa Hurek. Erica Rose Hurdle. Elma Huzerovich. Elif Ibis. Samara Irizarry. Samuel Irizarry Jr. Ryan Trinity Jackson. Michael Maximus Johannes. Jules Michaela Jones. Sage Jones. Sally Maria George. Sierra Morgan Judson. Sarah Grace Carwick. Madison Lee King. Nathan John Kitson. Annie Clementon. Emma Callie Clementon. Dylan William Knapp. Arzana Kunyusha. Jacob Michael Kozlowski. Haley Krozik. Andrew Labby. Presented by former councilwoman and board member Jody Latina, Luke Latina.
Can you say my middle name? Caroline, yeah.
Let's go, Gracie.
Thanks for watching. 1 second.
Gracie Caroline Leahy.
Thank you. Chanel.
Chanel Lewis.
Yeah, Lucella.
Lucella, okay.
John Douglas Lucella. Max Luna. Jackson McDonald.
Maher.
Aaron Austin Maher. Mahmoud Maki. Corey Mary Maliki. Nathan Malicki. Jordan Menduhano. Adrian Dyson Manrique. Adriana Alicia Mantia.
Marquio.
Samuele Marquio. Mark Marquive. Presented by Wethersfield Town Council member Dan O'Connor, Brendan McKinley Martin. Admir Masick. Jada Lynn McCallop. Chase Millen. Vincent Richard Meluzio. Ninelle Lana McCatsananian.
Close enough.
Francesco Molina. Allison Monroe.
Moquin?
Yeah.
Sean Joseph Moquin. Lily Rose Morrow. Ethan Michael Moreski. Alexia Grace Morrissey. Emily Grace Murphy. Matthew Murphy. Paige Morgan Usillo. Marcus Nieves. Camila Josefa Ribera Nobre. Anis Nurkic. John Francis O'Leary. Hannah Elizabeth Acasio. Samir Osmanovic. Ariana Padilla. Dimple Patel.
Petkowski.
Matthew Petkowski. Lillian Peak. Owen Ryan Pierce. Daniel Frank Pellegrino. Lauren Elizabeth Petura. Shelly Taylor Pettingill. Lauren Marie Pickering.
Pinchera.
Christopher Michael Pinchera. Julia Marie Pitchell. Kayla Rose Platania. Sam Duku Poku.
Oh,
Amanda Caitlin Price. Jake Robert Prunier. George Hector Rafty. Joseph Anthony Raposo. Aloysius Brian Ribeiro. Shannon Alicia Riley. Aaron Rexeppi.
Reyes.
Gustavo Reyes Alvarez. Elizabeth Deborah Rich. Madison Castagna Riggi. Natalie K. Rios. Nevaeh Marie Rios. Ethan Rushlow. Brian Rodriguez. Evelise Marie Rodriguez. Rolando Jaden Rodriguez. Amanda Michelle Roeder. Jada Marie Roger. Amelia Elizabeth Roakes. Veronica Rondinelli. Caitlin Rose Ryan. Audra Saladin. Julius Rafael Sanchez. Autumn Sankofa. Dominic James Sanzabrino. Giancarlo Sebastian Santapalo. Gino Santilli. Michaela Leanne Santos. Isabella Sanzo. Ava Sargent. Michael Paul Sargis. Morgan Ashley Sargis. Alyssa June Scalora. Dan Shorman. Robert Chavone.
Schlapfer.
Adam Schlapfler. Michael Keith Snyder. Juliana Isabella Sorayo. Jenna Sharp. Josh and Preet Singh. Evan James Sapala. Ethan Brian Sittler. Jonathan Stanley Skoranek. Ty Slazinski. Janelle Stefanski.
Full name.
Rory Bruce Stickley.
What is my full name? Paolina.
Yeah. Kathleen Paolina Sullivan. Krista Ann Semecki. Olivia May Semecki. Rohan Tahir. Isabella Taverny. Jules Thompson. Nicholas Thompson Jr. Olivia Ann Thompson. Tarjay Tibbs. Matthew Russell Tyne. Jenna Marie Tosh.
Franco Antonio Tomino.
Claire Elizabeth Tanucci. Erica Yari Torres.
Joyce Marie Torres.
Lorian Angela Tupons. Facilio Soporis. Amaya Marie Turcott. Isla Ternazic. Adriana Sophia Usello. Bhakti Vansadia. Brandon Hayes Vargas. Oscar Armando Velasco. Joshua Thomas Velasella. Amra Velik. Anna Valentina Villagra. Gabriella Karina Villagra. Edward John Wadsworth V. Alexia Irie Walker. Taylor Therese Wallowitz. Julia Rose Ward. Devin Elizabeth Welchel. Xavier Emmanuel White. Riley Grace Wilhelm. Hakeem Keyshawn Williams. Emily Bryn Wolf. Odin Wonder.
Zabalza. Yep.
Alessandro Zabalza. Ella Jane Zagaya.
Brendan Michael Zaleski. Lou John Zalez.
Do you want the third?
Zachary Andrew Zerzola III. Natalie Summer Zwick.
And now I call upon the class of 2021 to please rise. Our student officers, please to come forward. And now, led by class officers Tiago Nguyen, Carrie Nguyen, Brian Puglielli, and Victoria Villagra, I now direct members of the class to move their tassels from the right side of their mortarboard to the left side, signifying graduation from high school. Our commencement ceremonies are now completed. Congratulations and good luck to all the members of the Wethersfield High Class of 2021.
I saw her face.